Hi, I'm Hazel, and welcome to my beginner's intro to the TradeSkillMaster add-on. In this video, we're going to go through what TSM can do for you, installing it along with the TSM app, a quick tour of the tooltips, and we'll walk you through selling your first item. If you're brand new to TSM and have no idea where to start, this is for you. The first question is, what is TSM and why should I care? TSM stands for TradeSkillMaster, and it's basically a supercharged add-on for item management. The main purpose is taking your auction house experience to the next level and streamlining the process of making gold. It lets you post a ton of things for sale really quickly, see the going rate of an item right from its tooltip, find good deals on the auction house to buy your flip, manage mail, and figure out what to craft for profit. The system that makes all of that work is based on putting items into groups, and then you can treat those groups by custom sets of rules. For example, mail all lockboxes to my rogue, show me all battle pets in the auction house listed at under half of their market value, craft all enchants with at least 100 gold profit each, list these 300 different transmog pieces for 10 copper under whatever the last guy posted them at, the possibilities go pretty far. New in TSM 4, they've given us a base group that includes all ungrouped items, as well as a default operation to help get you up and running. That's a lot to process, and you don't need to know all of it right away. The short version is that once you're on your feet, TSM will help you save time and make more gold. Before we install anything, I will add a disclaimer that this is not the lightest add-on out there. It does a lot and uses a decent amount of resources relative to your average mod. Depending on the age and firepower of your PC, you may or may not notice some increased load-in times. It's a non-issue for me and many people, but it is something to be aware of as a possibility. Step 1 is installing TSM. This is a two-part process that should take maybe 5 minutes. First, we'll get the add-on. These days, you only need to grab two things from your Twitch app or the Curse site: TradeSkillMaster and TradeSkillMaster App Helper. I will link to both of those things in the description, or you can just search them up on the Twitch app. All of the TSM functions are now rolled into the base app in TSM 4, so you don't need to go looking for modules. Next, you'll really want the TSM app. This is a separate program that runs in your computer, and this is what gives TSM its up-to-date pricing info. The obvious questions that come up are, is it safe, and do I have to? The short answer to both is yes. It's always smart to be wary of third-party apps promising you big advantages, but this one is not a bot. This is perfectly account-safe, widely used, a pretty light piece of software that runs from your system tray, and it's free. It feeds TSM with current prices every 1 to 2 hours throughout the day. Without it, your data will only be as up-to-date as the last time that you sat down and did a massive full auction house scan, and that kind of ruins the whole experience. To get the TSM app, head over to tradeskillmaster.com/app, which I will link in the description. You will need a free account with their website in order to use it, so be ready for that. Give that a download and install it. Log into both their app and their website with that free account and add your realms at tradeskillmaster.com/realms. On the app, I recommend clicking Settings and checking Run at Startup, Start Minimized, and Minimize to System Tray so that it's always running. If it's not, you end up with old prices and that's no good. After you install, it does take some time to get your first wave of pricing data, so if the prices seem off, give it a few hours. With that done, let's fire up the game and check it out. Right away, the first benefit you'll get from having TSM installed is this fancy extra info in your item tooltips. This is completely customizable, so if it seems like a lot and you hate it, you can disable things you don't use. I'll walk you through what you get by default and where to personalize those settings. /TSM will get us back into our menu, and we'll go to Settings and Tooltip Settings. Pick any non-soulbound item to look at, and we'll walk through it together. For this fish, at the top we have a transform value, and that is telling me what I could get for this if I turn it into fish oil. Over here on the meat, you won't see that because we don't have aromatic meat oil yet. If you don't like that, you can turn it off here under destroying. Same goes for stuff that can be disenchanted, milled, prospected, etc. Under that, we have the vendor sell price, which is always good to know. If it's an item that you can buy from vendors, you'll be able to see that price too. You can turn those on and off here under main settings. Under that is inventory, which tells you how many of that item you have across your alts and whether they're in your mail, bank, whatever. That's really handy for tracking down pet charms, marks of honor, that kind of thing. You can turn that on or off in this drop-down menu under main settings. And now we get into the good stuff. The toggles for all of these are under value sources. Min buyout is the price of the cheapest one that's actually posted on your auction house as of the last hour or so. If you just want to undercut and move on with your day, that's probably what you're going to get for it. Market value is your realm's market value. TSM figures that out for you, and that will change over time. You can compare that with the min buyout to get a feel for what the item is worth on your server. If you're into the math, you can read more about TSM's market value algorithm in an article linked down below. We've also got region market value average, which is the current average market price across either NA or EU. That one I mostly use as a reference to check if the market value or min buyout look unusual. If this is way higher than the first two, then something might be fishy. At the bottom, region sale rate is a new stat in TSM4 that gives you an idea of how likely the item is to sell if you post it. Things like herbs sell very quickly and have a high sale rate, while a level 69 ring barely sells at all and has a much lower one. A 1 means it'll almost always sell if you post it, and a 0.03 means you've got roughly a 3% chance of finding a buyer. So play with those settings to get the tooltip of your dreams, although I do strongly recommend keeping at least min buyout and market price. It's so handy to just mouse over a thing and get an idea of what it's worth right away. Next, it's time to sell our first item. I have 8 meaty haunches and I'd like to sell them. I can just walk up to the auction house, click it here in this item in bags list, and press post selected. That brings us here where we can see the proposed price, stack and quantity, who's got the lowest one, and some info. So right away, the stack size is set to 1 and I want to post all 8. You don't want to be that dude posting a whole page of single stacks. So we can see that this is using the default operation, which we can fiddle with to fix that. To do that, type /TSM to open the options, or you can click on the mini-map icon. Go to Operations at the top, Auctioning on the left, and #default. Select Posting here, and we can clean this up a bit. You can change the default auction duration to 12, 24, or 48 hours. Let's edit that to 48, and let's max both the post cap and posted stack size to 200 and 1000. Make sure that you press your Enter key after changing a field so that your edit sticks. Leave the prices alone for now, go here and select Post at max price when above maximum, and we're set. We'll get into more detail at exactly what's going on here and how to set up your own auctioning operations in another video coming up soon. So now we can go back to the auctioneer, select our meaty haunches and anything else we want here, post selected, and post. If you ever want to just sell a couple of things real quick, that's the way to do it. Or we can select the base group here on the left, run a post scan, and that'll let us post everything in our bags by those same rules. Mashing the post button will post all of it, and you can use the skip to avoid posting things that you'd rather not sell. Now, most of the time you won't normally do that with the base group because it will try to sell everything that's not nailed down, including your potatoes, enchanting vellums, and vendor trash. It works great on a bank alt though, and it's a good intro to how we're going to post most of our auctions later on in this series. I am planning on doing a full set of TSM4 guides over the next couple of weeks to cover more topics and go a little deeper. Note that for now, TSM4 is still having some bugs ironed out of it. For me, it's been pretty functional these days. I'm not personally part of the TSM staff, but I will link their support website and Discord in the description where you can check for known issues or ask questions. So that's it for the intro. Congrats, you graduated. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and check back to my channel for more guides in this series as well as other WoW stuff. Let me know what you think and have a wonderful, wonderful day. Bye!